FM is KHTZ, Los Angeles. Good morning, it's 5:02. Good morning, it's Charlie Tuna, it's 5:08. Los Angeles is going to have some night, morning low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. High today and tomorrow should be near 72, overnight down to the middle 50s. Temps this morning, 55 downtown, 59 beaches, 59 Orange County, 55 valleys, and there's a little bit of fog out there. Here's Johnny.
Well, I spent a lifetime looking for you.
I bless the day I discovered.
KHTZ, K.Hits 97, Charlie Tuna and Johnny Lee. I'm looking for love in all the wrong places. Doesn't seem to be any down here this morning. Well, maybe tomorrow. 512. My telephone's open. Maybe that's the place. 520-9797, L.A. in the Valleys. Orange County, you can dial us at 977-1020. Now for a look at sports.
John Martin for Dallas National Sports, NHL Finals. Rangers 6, Flames 3, Bruins over the Sabres 5-1, North Star 6, Canadians 3, the lone NBA contest, Celtics 92, Pistons 90, Collegiate...
Consumer line. The U.S. Department of Energy has come up with some bad news for electric cars. Government investigators have reportedly decided that electric vehicles don't make enough noise. According to the Environmental Action Foundation, a government study has concluded that electric cars will have to be made noisier to prevent them from sneaking up on the unsuspecting pedestrians. The Department of Energy is hoping to have at least 10,000 electric cars purring rather loudly along U.S. highways by 1986. Maybe it would work if you all just turn up your radios real loud and roll down your windows.
Consumer line.
5:13. Played this yesterday morning, and now maybe on the last few hours over in Iran, the hostages waiting for the return to America. This is Neil Diamond from K-Hits 97, KHTZ. KHTZ, K-Hits, 97. Charlie Tuna, that's Neil Diamond in America. And hopefully today is the day. It's 5:18, the Los Angeles weather. Some night, morning, low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. Highs today and tomorrow should be near 72, overnight lows down to the middle 50s. Temps downtown at Civic Center, it's 55. Humidity is 59%. It's overcast along the beaches, 59s. Clouds in Orange County, it's 59. Clouds and some fog and haze you'll find in the valley areas this morning. Not so much in West L.A. as it was yesterday, but the valleys have some of the pea soup this morning's 55. Down in San Diego, it's clear skies and fog, and it's 55. Downtown. I have a note here, too. Unless you're perfectly satisfied with your present job, consider a career that pays up to $22,000 to start and offers real opportunity for advancement. The career is with the Los Angeles Police Department, and there are 500 immediate openings. If you're 21 to 34, have a high school diploma or GED, call the LAPD. You just might like what you hear. 5:18. McCartney and Wings on K-Hits 97. FM, Charlie Tuna, amazing, in this 5:24. This Thursday night, the K-Hits Concert Special, we're going to feature the music of Steely Dan. 1 hour, uninterrupted by commercials. Thursday night at 8, only here at K-Hits 97. FM, Charlie Tuna and Allie Thompson. Live every minute. The minutes are easy. It's the hours that start to get to you. 5:27. For all you record collectors out there, we'll have the tips from the Record Collector's Price Guide coming up on Celebrity Close-Up this morning. Here's Barbara Streisand and Barry Gibb. Guilty. KHTZ. K-Hits 97. Charlie Tuna, Barbara Streisand, and Barry Gibb. And where'd you get that guilty look on your face?
Good morning. I'm Boyd R. Britton, and at 5:31, here's your news. Yesterday, 24 hours ago exactly, I said, well, looks like day the last. Well, looks like day the last. One day later, I mean, really this time, we've done all we're supposed to. And according to the people from NBC in The Source, the planes really could take off at any time from Tehran. Here's Dara Wells.
We just received word that things are happening at the airport in Tehran. NBC News correspondent Fred Kennedy is standing by in London, where he's in contact with Tehran. Fred, what's happening now?
Six Algerian doctors just checked out of a hotel in Tehran. As they checked out, they turned to reporters and said, "It's all over. It's finished. We're going out to the airport to join the hostages on a flight to Algeria. These These are the six Algerian doctors who were checked the hostages yesterday. One of those doctors told us this morning everybody was well. They said they're saying goodbye. They're about to be free. Those are quotes. They're about to be free. These are according to the doctors in Tehran now. The Air Algiers 727, they're fully prepared, fully fueled. A flight plan has been submitted for takeoff. All of this follows money developments. Gotta wealth.
Thank you, Fred Kennedy in London. As Fred mentioned, about an hour ago, the White House announced that we have lived up to our part of the bargain with Iran and that frozen Iranian assets are now held by the Algerian Central Bank. So all that remained was for Iran to get official confirmation of this from Algeria. Iran's chief hostage negotiator said the hostages will then be freed. He says they are ready to fly. Eventually, the hostages are going to land at Wiesbaden, West Germany. NBC News correspondent Cameron Swayze is at our military hospital in Wiesbaden. Cameron, what's happening there now?
Dara, a short while ago, a military helicopter with a red cross painted on the fuselage made a low pass over the hospital, but then it flew off. It gave the impression of activity, but that's just an impression. This welcome and decompression period is on hold. Some new decorations are put out, some signs that read, "Welcome back." Some small American flags have been put up on the balconies. One sign says, "Welcome to Hotel Freedom."
Well, that'll be probably about 8 to 13 hours away, assuming the planes were to take off any second now. Obviously, they aren't even loaded yet. I don't know where we got those airport stories from yesterday. I'm a consumer of news sources here, just as you are. But on the 444th day, we have done our part financially, and Iran, if it lives up to the agreement it signed, is about to release the hostages at what exact time, we don't know. Could be hours away. Ronald Reagan's less than 4 hours away from his dream turning into stark reality as he will take the oath of office as the nation's 40th president, surrounded by heaters this morning and bulletproof glass. The heaters not only in the pockets of the Secret Service, but little space heaters around because of the chill in Washington. The inaugural gala, the most expensive ever, admittedly very privately supported for the most part, continues all day today, as well as the celebration if those planes take off from Tehran. Leftist guerrillas staged hit-and-run raids throughout El Salvador yesterday. The clashes with government troops leave plenty of civilian casualty, scores killed. Military officials, however, claim their troops have broken the rebel offensive, which has been going for over a week now, by killing, they claim, one-fourth of the leftist force. It always reminds me of Vietnam casualty reports, though, depending on which side you read. An estimated 10,000 armed peasants in Mexico have cut off roads to some of the rich oil fields there, claiming the government oil monopoly Pemex is ruining their crops. And this has paralyzed production of about, a third of a million barrels a day. Goodness. 181 people have filed papers to run for L.A. city office, including former Mayor Sam Yorty. Mayor Tom Bradley says the people have rejected Mayor Sam's style of politics, and he's sure they'll do it again, but it certainly makes the race more interesting. Oh, interesting, as long as we're talking about politicians. Veteran Los Angeles City Councilman Arthur Snyder is having his gallbladder out. A 21-year-old man was talked out of his suicide attempt on the edge of a Los Angeles high-rise building by a new friend who's going to help him get it back together now. The friend, praised by L.A. police, Muhammad Ali. I suppose Ed Arnold will tell us about that, as well as UCLA being ranked 14th in college basketball and USC winning last night. I don't have time to tell you this hour the story of Wendy O. Williams of the group called the Plasmatics. But we've got to read this sometime this morning. Insist on it, in or out of the news. At 5:36, your forecast, some night and morning low clouds, otherwise variable high clouds through Wednesday. Highs in the low 70s, it's 59 downtown.
Well, now, wait a minute. I've got time. Take my time right now.
She was arrested in Milwaukee following her usual nightclub act involving being dressed mainly in small pieces of electrical tape with her band, the Plasmatics, and they thought there may have been, was part of her performance is to smash up cars. You've heard of the Plasmatics. Uh-huh. They've played L.A. They sometimes use a chainsaw and guitars and things like that. Well, she was arrested for alleged obscene gestures, according to Milwaukee police, who may not know, but it was something to do with a sledgehammer. Now, maybe it was art. You know, you can't tell with the new wave.
It's 5:36.
Can't criticize too early. K-Hits 97.
KHTZ
KHTZ, K-Hits 97. Charlie Tuna and Fame, that's the name of the game. It's 5:41 today. Here's a little story, too, about, well, I don't know how many are Lou Grant fans out there, but last week when they had the Pacific Telephone Building fire, they had life imitating art. Daryl Anderson, the actor who plays the photographer, Old Animal, on the Lou Grant television series, happened to be shooting a scene for the show near the telephone company, and Anderson took a picture of the fire and wound up being distributed by AP to newspapers across the country. Another case of what came first, chicken or egg. Morning traffic update. We have a little fog in some of the valley areas this morning. Drive carefully there. The Golden State Freeway also north of Lake Hughes northbound. They have an accident with an injury and overturned vehicle. Traffic probably will be slowed in that area for the next 45 minutes. That's the northbound Golden State Freeway just north of Lake Hughes. Celebrity
close-up.
Today, a visit with Jerry Osborne, the author, editor of the Record Collector's Price Guide.
We've got a series which now numbers 9 books, Charlie, and in all related to music or collecting of music in one way or another.
Well, what are some of the titles that people would be looking for?
Well, the Record Collector's series, for one thing, has the pop and rock singles of 1948 to present. Another title is the Pop and Rock Album Guide, which also covers LPs from the time they started on 12-inch right through to present-day LPs. Another one is called The Complete Elvis, which deals just strictly with Elvis records and collectibles. There are others, 55 years of recorded country music, and one called A Guide to Record Collecting, which is actually a compendium of all of the aforementioned and is aimed strictly at the beginner or the novice collector.
Now, when we talked originally, there was a quote I had seen about the original recording of Stormy Weather by the Five Sharps was just about the highest priced 45. Is that still true?
So far, nothing has topped that. That record sold for just under $4,000 a couple of years back, and no record as of yet has approached that mark. However, there is an interesting little anecdote that I'd like to pass on. A collector, while going through some records in a junk store in Burbank, turned up an LP that was released by RCA as a sampler of some of their various new titles back in 1958. And one of the songs on the LP was King Creole by Elvis. And the collector, not knowing the value of the record and not having any previous documentation of it, offered it for sale, and it was snapped up for $1,000. So there's an instance of how a $1.98 junk store find can turn into real gold. Jan and Dean and Beach Boy Records are two notables in the area of mid-60s surf-sounding recordings that have a tremendous cult following. And anytime you have a cult following for an artist, such as Jan and Dean, the Beach Boys, Bob Dylan, Rolling Stones, Elvis, Beatles, and so forth, you're always going to have a real active market for the rarer or scarcer recordings by those artists.
Celebrity
close-up.
Good morning, it's 5:43 on K-Hits 97, KHTZ. KHTZ, K-Hits 97, and Charlie Tuna, Tequila Sunrise, that's the Eagles, 5:46, another love song. By the way, love songs aren't just for romantic humans. There's a researcher at the University of Florida who's discovered the male jumping spider courts his mate by singing a love song. G.B. Edwards, a graduate student, says the song is a two-tone trill that can be heard 3 feet away. The male creates the sound by rubbing together two internal sections of a pair of rod-like structures on either side of its mouth. He says of the song, it's a way of advertising his presence to the female and testing her reaction. Thanks, I'll stick to records. Los Angeles weather, some night and morning low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. The high today and tomorrow is 72. Overnight should get down to the middle 50s. Yesterday's high at Civic Center was 74, and it's 59 downtown. It's 58 and cloudy along the beaches. Overcast in Orange County, 59. It's clouds and some fog in the valleys and 55 down in San Diego. Partly cloudy fog and 54.
Ladies and gentlemen, now Pacific Stereo is bringing back the good old American penny. Pacific Stereo is having a 1 cent sale. Now through the end of January, 1 red cent will get you 1 sensational stereo or video bonus. Pick up any turntable and get an Empire cartridge for 1 cent more. Buy any home cassette deck and get 3 Maxell cassettes for 1 cent. Buy any receiver and Pacific Stereo will give you a pair of Newmark stereo headphones for 1 cent. Buy any compact music system or video cassette recorder and get the display rack to show it off for just 1 cent. There are lots more 1 cent specials, so come on in. Put those good old American pennies back to work. Pacific Stereo's 1 cent sale now through the end of January.
It just makes good sense.
Welcome here to Pacific Stereo.
Remember, there's an expert service department in every Pacific Stereo store.
It's 548 on K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. Charlie Tuna, a little celebration going on. Well, there is in Washington today, in just about 3 hours from now. It's 5:52 for a check on sports.
John Martin for Dowd National Sports, NHL Finals. Rangers 6, Flames 3, Bruins over the Sabres 5-1, North Star 6, Canadians 3, the lone NBA contest, Celtics 92, Pistons 90, Collegiate League 3, Memphis State 91, Tulane 79, USC 67, Arizona 63.
In and out, quality you can taste.
Yes, it's bumper sticker sweepstakes time again at In and Out. Over 300 chances to win. And winners are selected at random from cars spotted with an In and Out Burger bumper sticker and are identified by their license plate numbers. Listen to these prizes. 8 free trips to Hawaii for 2 people for 1 week, including round-trip airfare and hotel, Betamax home video recorders, Marantz stereo systems, portable black and white Zenith TV sets, and In and Out Burger gift certificates. Over 300 winners in all. No purchase necessary. Simply drive into your nearby In-N-Out Burger and ask for your free bumper sticker. Put it on your car right away. And who knows, maybe you'll be one of the more than 300 lucky winners.
In-N-Out, that's what a hamburger's all about. In-N-Out.
It's 5:53. This guy's been about the hottest thing going in the music business this past year. Kenny Rogers, and Love the World Away. Just make the morning go away. I'll come back a little later. K-Hits 97.
Every now and then.
97 FM. Charlie Tuna, Love the World Away. Kenny Rogers. It's 5:57. KHTZ, Los Angeles. Charlie Tuna and Diana Ross, and I'm coming out.
Good morning. It's 6:01. I'm Boyd R. Britton, and here's your news. Here's what we're hoping, that if there are no more snags, we can tell you soon about a takeoff from Tehran, but we can't yet. All we can tell you is what they're saying at the White House today, which is as final as you can get without saying the hostages are on their way home.
United States government is now on record as expecting the imminent release of the American hostages in Iran. That word came from presidential spokesman Jody Powell just about 3.5 hours before the end of the Carter administration. Powell said President Carter was informed at 8:17 local time this morning that the government of Algeria has notified Iran that the deposits of previously frozen Iranian assets into an escrow account have been completed. What that means is that the United States, according to Powell, has completed its share of the bargain in giving up control over the frozen Iranian funds. Based on that, Powell says, and these are his words, "We have every right to expect and do expect the expeditious release of our hostages." Tom Foti at the White House.
If those planes do take off, the one carrying, of course, the hostages, the other carrying their baggage, we'll probably hear about it first through Fred Kennedy, the NBC source correspondent in London, who has been ahead of many developments because of his contacts in Tehran. And he talks about the doctors, 6 Algerian physicians, who have left their dwelling, hotel I presume, in Tehran and headed for the airport, saying they're ready to leave with the 52 Americans.
It's a 30-minute trip to Tehran airport, so they're probably there now. As they left their hotel to head for the airport, they said, quote, "It's finished. We're off to join the hostages on a flight to Algeria. Now, we've been talking to Tehran Air Traffic Control. They say the planes are ready. The baggage is loaded. They will not confirm that the passengers are there. However, they are saying that the destination is now Algeria, with a possible stopover in Ankara. The trip would be probably 7.5 hours from Tehran to Ankara, or rather, Tehran to Algiers, and then another 4 hours after that to Frankfurt. We're getting more information in all the time. We're told that the hostages may very possibly be heading out to the airport if they are not there already, because we are having suggestions that the doctors are with the hostages, which would seem like a likely procedure."
Indeed it would. Fred Kennedy of NBC in London on day 444, perhaps the last. Didn't like that 11th hour hitch yesterday. Made us all look a little too anxious, but boy, are we ever. President-elect Reagan is anxious. In a very few hours, he will be the 40th president of the United States, the oath of office being taken at the Capitol, of course, and a brief speech is planned, as usual, the speech talking about how America can, indeed, take new directions as we begin a whole new era, or so Reagan and everybody really hopes. We don't want to go any further down than we have. The Reagans will go to the White House for a little breakfast with the Carters before they all motor up Pennsylvania Avenue for the swearing-in. And, of course, tonight, Ronald Reagan will be sleeping in the White House. They will make the changeover that quickly. The president-elect last night was entertained by a parade of stars from showbiz, mainly Hollywood, in a big extravaganza in suburban Washington. He spent his final night as a private citizen at Blair House. And as he takes the oath, the Senate plans to act quickly today to confirm as many Reagan cabinet appointees as possible. Donovan is still delayed as Labor Secretary-designate because of unspecified allegations against him concerning his career in the New Jersey construction industry. Five reputed leaders of the West Coast Mafia are scheduled to be sentenced today in L.A. It was the Jimmy the Weasel trial, and Pat Gaffey reports.
Five men said to be leaders of the West Coast Mafia will be sentenced in federal court this morning. Back in November, they were convicted after a month-long racketeering trial. Two of them were also found guilty of extortion. One man was identified during the trial as the boss of the Los Angeles La Cosa Nostra family for the past 8 years, except for a period of time when he was in a federal penitentiary. Another has been in the mafia since the 1940s. The FBI and the Department of Justice prosecutors are asking the judge in this case to sentence these men with heavy prison terms, citing the serious danger they pose to society because of their involvement in America's most notorious criminal organization ever, the mafia. Pat Gaffey, K-Hits, 97.
Okay, Pat. It's 6:05 at Arnold Sports in 20 minutes with a USC win to talk about, among other things. And the weather in L.A. today, partly cloudy most of the day. Some high clouds later, the low clouds right now, of course, and again tonight and early tomorrow. Highs today and Wednesday in the low 70s. It's 59 and cloudy downtown.
It's amazing the steps in science that are being taken these days, Boyd. A scientist at Warwick University in England claimed to have developed an artificial nose, which can distinguish different smells.
Oh, I see.
Nose.
Well, the prosthetic ones have been around for years.
This one, they say.
Many decorator colors.
Yes, has been designed for use in factory production lines for quality control and perfume and also soap and beer. And they say it'll monitor levels of anesthetics in the atmosphere. Sphere of hospitals, too.
Oh, in other words, it's just a gaseous diffusion sensor.
That's right.
No, okay.
606.
K-Hits 97. KHTC. KHTC. K-Hits 97. At Charlie Tuna, Chicago. And you can call on me, 610. My telephone's 520-9797. LA in the Valleys, Orange County, 977-1020. We'll check morning traffic for you in a minute. And Monty Python with the Argument Clinic and the Breakfast Cereal.
The L.A. County Fairgrounds will be rocked with shockwaves as drag racing's top fuelers and funny cars rev it up in the NHRA Winter Nationals. Don't lose a millisecond. Head for the nearest Pepsi display where you'll find special race coupons. They're good for savings on general admission, pit passes, and a discount offer for an official Winter Nationals t-shirt. So get ready for the NHRA Winter Nationals coming to the L.A. County Fairgrounds January 29th through February 1st. Look for special discount coupons at Pepsi displays. And when you're at the races, step up and take the Pepsi Challenge. The official track record shows Pepsi's the winner.
Catch that Pepsi spirit. Drink it in, drink it in, drink it in. Catch that Pepsi spirit. Drink it in, drink it in.
Leo Stereo's gigantic store-wide clearance sale is happening right now. Save up to 70% on Leo's entire stock of car stereos, car speakers, portables, turntables, home speakers, tape decks, receivers, TVs, video equipment, and all accessories. Millions of dollars worth of merchandise from all famous brand names. And for an extra added bonus, Leo's has a special supply of merchandise at unbelievable bargains. Included in this sale, discontinued items, scratch and dent, demos, slow movers, and brand new product too. Shop early for the best selection, for quantity is limited to stock on hand. And for your convenience, all Leo's locations have car installation departments with expert installers. Bring cash, checkbook, good credit, and most major credit cards are accepted. This is one sale you can't afford to miss. Leo's Stereo's gigantic store-wide clearance sale with up to 70% off.
It's 6:12. Here's a morning traffic update. First of all, from the last hour, northbound on the Golden State Freeway, north of Lake Hughes, had an accident with injury in an overturned vehicle, and traffic probably slowed in that area for about another 15 minutes. That's northbound Golden State, north of Lake Hughes. Santa Ana Freeway below the Laguna area in Orange County, southbound, they have an accident with about 1,000 gallons of oil spilled. Traffic is being diverted at that location, southbound on the Santa Ana Freeway right below the Laguna Connector Freeway. And the San Bernardino Freeway at Havenhurst, outbound, number 3 lane. They have spilled diesel fuel out there. So a lot of spilled loads this morning. Drive carefully. It's 6:13.
And now, the morning breakfast cereal.
I'd like to have an argument, please.
Certainly, sir. Have you been here before?
No, I haven't. This is my first time.
I see. Well, do you want to have just one argument, or were you thinking of taking a course?
Well, what is the cost?
Well, it's £1 for a 5-minute argument, but only £8 for a course of 10.
Well, I think it would be best if I perhaps started off with just the one and then see how it goes.
Fine. Well, I'll see who's free at the moment. Mr. DeBakey's free, but he's a little bit conciliatory. Ah, yes. Try Mr. Barnard, room 12.
Thank you.
What do you want?
Well, I was told outside that...
Don't give me that, you vacuous, coffee-nosed, malodorous pervert!
Look, I came here for an argument. I'm not going to just...
Oh, I'm sorry, but this is abuse.
Oh, I see. Well, that explains...
Oh, yes. You want room 12A, just along the corridor.
Oh, thank you very much. Sorry.
Not at all.
Thank you.
Stupid git.
Come in.
Is this the right room for an argument?
I told you once.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have.
When?
Just now.
No, you didn't.
I did.
Didn't.
Did.
Didn't.
I'm telling you, I did.
You did not.
Oh, I'm sorry. Just one moment. Is this a 5-minute argument or the full half hour?
Oh, just the 5 minutes.
Ah, thank you. Anyway, I did.
You most certainly did not.
Look, let's get this thing clear. I quite definitely told you.
No, you did not.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
You didn't.
Did.
Well, look, this isn't an argument.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't. It's just contradiction.
No, it isn't.
It is.
It is not.
Look, you just contradicted me.
I did not.
Oh, you did.
No, no, no.
You did just then.
Nonsense.
Oh, look, this is futile.
No, it isn't.
I came here for a good argument.
No, you didn't. No, you came here for an argument.
Well, an argument isn't just contradiction.
Can be?
No, it can't. An argument is a connected series of statements intended to establish a proposition.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. It's not just contradiction.
Look, if I argue with you, I must take up a contrary position.
Yes, but that's not just saying no, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't. Argument is an intellectual process. Contradiction is just the automatic gainsaying of any statement the other person makes.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
Not at all.
Now, look.
Good morning.
What?
That's it. Good morning.
I was just getting interested.
Sorry, 5 minutes is up.
That was never 5 minutes.
I'm afraid it was.
It wasn't.
I'm sorry, but I'm not allowed to argue anymore.
What?
If you want me to go on arguing, I'll have to pay for another 5 minutes.
Yes, but that was never 5 minutes just now. Oh, come on. Look, this is ridiculous.
I'm sorry, but I'm not allowed to argue unless you've paid.
Oh, all right.
Thank you.
Well?
Well, what?
That wasn't really 5 minutes just now.
I told you, I'm not allowed to argue unless you've paid.
I just paid.
No, you didn't.
I did.
No, you didn't.
Look, I don't want to argue about
that. No, you didn't pay.
Aha! If I didn't pay, why are you arguing? I've got you.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have. If you're arguing, I must have paid.
Not necessarily. I could be arguing in my spare time.
Oh, I've had enough of this.
No, you haven't.
Oh, shut up. I want to complain.
You want to complain? Look at these shoes on. I only had them 3 weeks and the heels are worn right through.
No, I want to complain.
If you complain, nothing happens. You might as well not bother.
Oh.
And my back hurts and whenever it's a fine day and I'm sick and tired of this office.
Hello, I want to...
Oh!
No, no, no. Hold your head like this. Then go, wow. Try it again.
Oh!
Better, better, but wow, wow. Put your hand there.
No.
Now.
Wow!
Wow, good, that's it.
Stop hitting me.
What?
Stop hitting me.
Stop hitting you?
Yes.
Why'd you come here then?
I wanted to complain.
Oh, no, that's next door. It's being hit on the head lessons in here.
What a stupid concept.
Tune in again tomorrow for another breakfast cereal. 6:16 on K-Hits 97, KHTZ.
K.H. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. Every woman in the world, that's air supply. It's Charlie Tuna at 619. Oh, talking about women, this should be a good year for women because researchers at the University of Southern California report that as of 1981, the number of men of marriageable age outnumbers their female counterparts for the first time in decades. A sociologist over at USC, David Hears, said a marriage squeeze for men is predicted in the mid-80s. The so-called buyer's market for women will occur because of the declining birth rate over the past 25 years, combined with the fact that men marry women an average of 2.5 years younger than themselves. Here claims that with fewer women available to marry, men will be forced to compensate women more. It says here the amount of money women receive from their husbands will increase, so will the decision-making power women have in marriage. He who controls the purse strings, what is it? Los Angeles weather, some night, morning, low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. High today and tomorrow should be near 72. Yesterday's high at Civic Center, I thought it was 74, it's 70. That was the top temperature we got downtown. Overnight down to the middle 50s. Temperatures now, downtown at Civic Center, it's 59. Along the beaches, overcast, 58. Some clouds at Orange County, and it's 59. In the valleys, it's clouds and some fog, and 55 down in San Diego. Partly cloudy and some fog in 54.
Hi. Do you know those great restaurants in California called Charlie Brown's? I've been enjoying lunches and dinners here almost as long as they've been serving them. 16 years now. They're called the Prime Steak Place because they won't serve a steak unless it's USDA Prime. But everything at Charlie Brown's is top-notch, including the value. And for Charlie Brown's 16th anniversary, they've come up with some delicious deal. Sort of a thank you for your 16 years of loyalty. Many of you know about Charlie Brown's Sunset Special, a complete prime rib dinner for $7.95, if you come in before 7 p.m. But during January, they're extending this offer to any time from 5 p.m. till closing, Sunday through Thursday night. You'll get the same succulent prime rib with soup or salad, even dessert and coffee for just $7.95. So come to Charlie Brown's during January. It's a great chance for old friends to get together and new ones to discover why Charlie Brown's has been California's prime steak place for so many years.
Tuesday on NBC TV, Lobo, Birdie, and Perkins are going to need all the help they can get when they uncover a hot car ring that uses pretty girls as bait. Then, a sexy saboteur sets up BJ, and it's up to the seven lady truckers to save him. Then, Lane's dark secret is just the thing Titus needs to run her off Flamingo Road. Can Field or Sam stop him? An all-new Lobo, BJ and the Bear, and Flamingo Road. Tuesday on NBC Television. Consult local listings for time and channel.
It's 622 on K-Hits 97. KHTC, K-Hits 97. Knowing me, knowing you. The nose knows. Zappa, Charlie Tuna, 626, Ed Arnold in a minute.
Is the Energizer just another battery? Is the World Series just another game?
The Energizer.
Of all leading brands, nothing you can buy outlasts the Energizer. We took the most commonly used battery sizes, tested their overall average performance, and found nothing outlasts the Energizer.
The Energizer.
In the World Series of leading battery brands, nothing outlasts the Energizer. Nothing. The Energizer. Most powerful energy source ever from EverReady Technology. Switch to the Energizer for all your energy needs. If your photo flash, electronic game, toy could talk, they'd tell you,
"Energize me." The Energizer.
The Energizer. Ever ready at its powerful best.
The Energizer. Energize. For life.
Long life.
627, and now Ed Arnold joins us. Morning, Ed.
Good morning, Charlie. How you doing?
I was reading today about the San Antonio Spurs incentive plan that they have. The more wins they get, the more money everybody on the team makes. And you tell me that's at least happens in one other case, right?
Well, yeah, it's happened this year at the Los Angeles Kings. Jerry Buss wanted to get a little bit more motivation, and he threw in a trip to Hawaii for the whole team if they hit X number of wins, which they're going to hit.
Is that what it takes now in sports?
Well, yeah, it's funny what they've done, and I think in both cases it's to kind of knock off the old adage that, well, the pros are spoiled, they make too much money, they don't want to work.
Mm-hmm.
And what this is to show, hey, these guys get X number of dollars, and with a little extra effort, look what else they get, so they're not going to slough off.
Dangle a little carrot out there.
Well, it's funny, San Antonio, it's worked. I mean, set up, what they did is they set it up that said they'd start paying these bonuses, which are pretty fat, too. From about $500 up to about $15,000 for the Iceman, George Gervin. But it starts with victory number 35, and they're almost there now.
Well,
of course, the fact they've got Stan Allback as an outstanding coach hasn't hurt them in their winning this year either.
Right. Well, what have you got on our sports items this morning?
Well, we've got a lot of stuff. First of all, the Lakers and Kings both enjoyed a day of rest. The Kings host Detroit tonight at the Forum while the Lakers resume action tomorrow night. With sports, I'm Ed Arnold.
All right, we'll catch you in about 30 minutes. We'll have to talk about UCLA basketball on TV tonight, but it's not who you think, right?
You're right. We'll tell them about a great player they may not know anything about.
All right. 629 on K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. Bette Midler, Charlie Tuna, and My Mother's Eyes.
Good morning. I'm Boyd R. Britton. Here's your news at 6:31. The planes could leave at any time, apparently, from Tehran. This as the U.S. announces that we expect the expeditious release of our hostages, because we have every right to, in the words of Jody Powell, as he confirmed that Algeria has told Tehran that they have received in London the principal deposits in the escrow account that is designed to return frozen Iranian assets to Tehran in exchange for the hostages, tonight when the inaugural celebration hits full party-level swing. Anyway, they will, of course, be asking the president not to do things. What do you want the president to do as he takes office? What do you want as first priority from the Reagan administration? That is the topic of our telephone poll this morning on K-Hits. The number to call is 520-9797. For getting through the day in L.A., you're going to have variable cloudiness, low stuff this morning, high stuff this afternoon, more stuff down on the shoreline, especially tonight and early tomorrow.
A lot of
highs in the low 70s, yeah. And it's 58 degrees and cloudy downtown.
And you said our space heaters that were in the building originally for
have been commandeered to surround the president behind his bulletproof glass as he makes his inaugural speech.
Right. 6:36. We'll play this next one. Some listener called him, suggested it might be a good song for the hospital.
You hear his teeth chatter. You know why.
Okay, it's 97.
The long and winding road.
KHTZ, K-Hits 97, and Charlie Tuna and the Long and Winding Road. Hopefully the hostages will get to take that one back home today. It's 6:40, we'll check the traffic for you in a second.
An unplanned pregnancy is hard to deal with. Think about it. Who do you talk to? Where do you go? The doctors at West Coast Medical Group have helped thousands of women in the last 10 years. Our services include help for those with an unplanned pregnancy and free pregnancy testing. Additionally, we offer continuing gynecological care and birth control services. Our professional staff is always ready to talk to you in strict confidence. Call us. We're specialists in complete women's health care. Call West Coast Medical Group. Whether you have Medi-Cal or have health insurance, or if you're just looking for a reasonable price for specialized medical care, call West Coast Medical Group in Hollywood, Los Angeles, and the San Fernando Valley. The number? 856-8655. If you forget the number, look in the white pages under West Coast Medical Group. Call now, 856-8655.
For the first time in 8 years, Weight Watchers has changed its program to include those foods that Weight Watcher members have missed most.
Hmm.
And that sensational new diet program with 11 Weight Watcher recipes, a behavioral modification plan, and tips to take the calories out of cooking is exclusively in the new Family Circle magazine.
Now I can lose weight and eat everything.
Most everything. Champagne, beer, wine, and bagels and English muffins.
What about olives, popcorn, sweet potatoes, or peanut butter?
Family Circle says yes.
Oh, I'm gonna love this diet.
That's why Weight Watchers made the change, to keep up with the way people eat today. With Family Circle, you can follow Weight Watchers program in your home. The same safe, steady weight loss program that Weight Watchers follow in their weekly classes.
I'm going to love this diet.
The only place you'll find it other than Weight Watchers is Family Circle magazine. Just 59 cents. Look for the luscious cherries and cream roll on the cover.
Oh, cream roll? Oh, that's not approved.
Well, you can't have everything.
6:42. This morning traffic update, Santa Ana Freeway at the Laguna Freeway. This morning southbound, they had an earlier accident, had an oil spill, about 1,000 gallons of oil spilled out there. Still being cleared, traffic is being diverted at the Laguna Freeway. Also, the Golden State Freeway north of Lake Hughes Road. They had an earlier accident out there with an injury, an overturned vehicle. Traffic will probably be backed up in that area for another couple of minutes out there. So problems on the freeway so far. There's a little bit of patchy fog, too, in the valley areas. Drive carefully. It's 6:43, and Christopher Cross from K-Hits 97. KHTZ. KHTZ, K-Hits 97, and Charlie Tuna, Christopher Cross. Never going to be the same again. It's 647, the Los Angeles weather. Some night and morning low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. High today and tomorrow, 72. Yesterday's high downtown was 70 at the Civic Center. Overnight lows down to the middle 50s. Civic Center this morning is 58 along the beaches. It's 58 and overcast in Orange County. It's clouds and 59. Cloudy mixed with some fog in the valleys today. It's 58. Partly cloudy and some fog down towards San Diego, and it's 56. And a playback of the telephone poll as to how you would like to see President Reagan start his term in office today. We'll be coming up in a minute.
The more you know about value, the more you'll like about Ralph's. For instance, right now, Ralph's offers you important savings on genuine USDA choice steaks. And these are just a few of the values at every Ralph's market. You'll find as many as 15,000 more. USDA choice T-bone steak, thick and flavorful, only $2.49 a pound. Save 40 cents a pound. USDA choice top sirloin steak, tender and juicy, only $2.59 a pound. Save 50 cents a pound. Large red grapefruit, only 25 cents each. Tide detergent, the big 49-ounce box, only $1.57. Save 46 cents. Ralph's chilled orange juice from Florida, half-gallon carton, only 99 cents. Save 40 cents. Because of these super low prices, quantities on some items are limited. Prices effective through Wednesday, January 21st at all Ralph's markets. You're doing your share at Ralph's. We're doing ours.
Diana Ross, live at the Fabulous Forum. Hear the music that's made her the number one recording artist in America. An elegant evening with Diana. That's Diana Ross, live in concert at the Fabulous Forum, Thursday, February 5th at 8:30 p.m. Tickets now on sale at the Forum box office, Sears, Ward's, and Tower Records. Don't miss Diana Ross, live and in the round, February 5th at 8:30 p.m.
Why do people choose the Sports Connection over some other clubs?
Well, the last health club I was at was too boring. All they had was one dumbbell, and he was the instructor.
Hey, did they have a small swimming pool? It doubled as an ice cube tray today.
I asked the instructor how to take weight off my legs, and he stole my shoes.
Well, the other club had this once-in-a-lifetime membership plan. Well, that's because the club was so bad, you only wanted to go
once in a lifetime.
You know what it's like at some other clubs. That's why we started the Sports Connection, the total fitness center. Everything from racquetball and swimming to slimnastic classes and Nautilus, and more people on staff to make sure you do it right. Come see the Sports Connection before you hear yourself say,
did the other place pressure me to join? No, I always wear these thumb screws.
Okay, now you've made that New Year's resolution to deblob yourself. Now's the time to act. Right now, you can get 2 years at the Sports Connection for the price of one. A two-year membership for the price of one. Right now, all Sports Connection locations. Santa Monica, Beverly Hills, San Encino. It's 6:49, time for the playback of our telephone poll. The 6:30 news question this morning is, what would you like to see President Reagan accomplish as he takes office today? And the answers?
If Reagan gets in, I'd like him to get the hostages back if they're not already back.
All right. Telephone poll.
I think the first thing I would like to see the president do is do something for this country for a while. You know, work on domestic policy for a while and get this place straightened around before we go running around the world. You know, I want to help other people, but I think we need to take care of our own people first.
Telephone poll.
Yes, I'd like President Reagan to get rid of the busing issue situation.
Thank you. Telephone poll.
Yes, I think Ronald Reagan could do a good thing for the country right when he got in office if he resigned.
Thank you. Telephone poll.
I think he should build up our defense against Russia.
Thank you. Telephone poll.
I agree.
Telephone poll.
I think that after we get the hostage back, I think we should blow up Iran.
Thank you. Telephone poll.
Yes, my name is Pablo Suarez, and what I want President Reagan to do is to bring the pride back to the U.S. Armed Forces. I want them to keep this from happening again to our country by letting any other country take over or, get us where they want us and, you know, making us the laughing stock of the world. I mean, that's not very funny anymore. It might make other countries lose faith in us.
Telephone poll.
I realize there's so many problems, it's really hard to just bring it down to one, but I have three children, and I have them in private schools. I think that he should work on the public school, because our children of today are what's going to happen tomorrow. They need that knowledge.
Thank you. Telephone poll.
I would like to see
Ronald Reagan, start behaving like a president and leave that whole Hollywood scene behind him. And a great example of that was that inaugural fiasco they had last night that I thought was in very, very poor taste while the hostages are being released.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Telephone poll.
Telephone poll?
Yes. Wrong number? I guess so. That's going to have to wrap it up. That's some of your opinions as to what you would like to see the president accomplish as he takes office today. It's 6:52 on K-Hits 97, KHTZ.
You're a rich girl.
KHTZ, K-Hits 97, and Charlie Tuna and a rich girl. That's 6:54. And now here's the rich guy, Ed Arnold. Good morning, Ed.
Good morning, and that's a joke.
Well, I thought we set it up here in the media. It's all done with strings and mirrors anyway, right?
Yes, that's right. It's funny what a lot of people think.
Well, now tonight, we talked about 30 minutes ago, the UCLA basketball on the television, Channel 5, but
yes,
a little different, right?
Right. It's the women's basketball team this time.
Uh-huh.
And they're going to, I'll tell you, the folks who get a chance to watch the game are going to be in for a treat because they're going to see one of the finest basketball players in the nation. Denise Curry of UCLA is three. Mo Williams led Troy with 23 points. That's sports for Toyota. I'm Ed Arnold. And hey, Charlie, about an hour from now, we ought to talk about the Ali thing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's going to be... it's hard to tell whether that's like a news item or a sports item.
But we'll talk about it. I mean, you know, yeah. Boyd R., let's give him a break. You know, this is a sports guy.
All right. 6:58. Linda Ronstadt, K-Hits 97, KHTZ.
Good morning. I'm Boyd R. Britton. Here's your news at 7:01. Within the hour, that plane could, should take off, says who? Says Secretary of State Muskie, among others. We also have confirming information on the imminent release of the hostages from Tehran from Bob Madigan of The Source.
Contact with the airport tower in Tehran indicates flight plans have been filed. The baggage is aboard the plane, and the hostages may already be in their freedom jet. Takeoff could come at any moment. The hostages, of course, won't be considered free until they leave Iranian airspace. The first stop will probably be Algiers, where the hostages will be transferred to some U.S. Air Force flying hospital planes. Then it's off to West Germany, the U.S. military air base at Rhein-Main. The official word from the White House is the final step in the banking procedure was taken 3 hours ago. Frozen Iranian assets were transferred to the Central Bank of Algiers.
Well, what happens next? When the hostages arrive in Wiesbaden, we assume that that's the first time they'll get any rest. Will they get to see their relatives? Well, the State Department suggested that a decompression period would be the best idea, saying that the families perhaps could wait a bit before racing to Germany. And indeed, the government is not providing transportation. Some airlines, or like Braniff, I believe, is offering free rides to the hostages to any place they can carry them that's convenient. Highs in the low 70s. It's 58 downtown.
I was noting about Ronald Wilson Reagan, as you announced him.
Yeah, I finally learned it's not Boris or Louise.
But you know Harry S. Truman? The S didn't stand for anything.
Right, he just wanted a middle initial.
David O. Selznick, same thing. No meaning, just they wanted...
I thought he was Irish.
706.
I see.
706 on KHTZ 97. KHTZ. Charlie Tuna, Neil Diamond. Love on the Rocks. It's 7:10. We'll check the morning traffic for you in just a second. I have a lady on the telephone, too. First, though, here's a K-Hits skiers update.
In the Southland Mountains, they have reopened at Gold Mine. They did, in fact, reopen over the weekend. They also have reduced rates. I'm Jeff Schaefer in San Francisco.
That's the latest from the slopes and K-Hits.
What makes a great salesperson? One thing we know for sure, it takes a lot more than a terrific personality.
With STP. 7:12 for News Beyond the Road. The morning freeway update. Santa Ana Freeway just below the Laguna Freeway southbound. Earlier oil spill. Still being cleared. They spilled about 1,000 gallons of oil out there. Traffic affected most of the morning. That's southbound on the Santa Ana Freeway. Just below the Laguna Freeway, you are being diverted at that location. The southbound San Diego Freeway into the Sepulveda Pass. Traffic is really heavy and congested already this morning in that area. The Newport Freeway south of 17th Street, southbound. They have a tire in the roadway, possible hazard. Ventura Freeway inbound, eastbound at Woodman. They have some law enforcement activity going on in that area. And the southbound Golden State transition to the inbound Pasadena Freeway. They have an accident. It's an overturned vehicle and traffic is slowed in that area. Drive carefully. 7:13. Well, yesterday morning on the, we got a kick about, we've been asking you to take kids to work with you, right? You enjoy the music all day long. And we started getting up an idea premise that we kicked around in the office last week. Listening to K-Hits 97 at work is like. And ladies on the phone here with one addition this morning. What was it?
I think it's like being in a fantasy land and getting paid $8 a day to do it.
They're playing. 7:13. Dancing? K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. And Charlie Tuna, working my way back. Spinners at 7:18. My telephone's open, by the way. Any additions to listening to K-Hits 97 at work is like, you always give me a call. I have a couple of numbers. They are working, aren't they? Okay. 520-9797, LA in the Valleys, Orange County, 977-1020. 7:18, the Los Angeles weather. Some night, morning low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. The high today and tomorrow, 72. Overnight down to the middle 50s. Yesterday's high downtown was 70. This morning, temps 57 at Civic Center, and the humidity just reversed that, comes out 75%. It's overcast at the beaches and 58. It's cloudy in Orange County at 58. Had some early morning light fog, too, in the valleys, as well as some dense fog in earlier parts, too. It's overcast 53 right now, partly cloudy and some fog at Hayes in San Diego, and it's 56.
Is the Energizer just another battery? Is the Kentucky Derby just another horse race? Of all leading brands, nothing you can buy outlasts the Energizer. We took the most commonly used battery sizes, tested their overall average performance, and found nothing outlasts the Energizer.
The Energizer!
No matter what you've heard, no matter what anyone claims, no leading brand makes a longer-lasting battery than the Energizer. No way, no how. The Energizer from EverReady Technology. Switch to it for all your energy needs. If your electronic game, flashlight, cassette recorder could talk, they'd tell you,
"Energize me."
The Energizer.
The Energizer. EverReady at its powerful best.
The Energizer. Energize for life.
Long life.
I just picked up the telephone. There's a gentleman on there. Hi, who's this?
This is Larry Burns.
Hi, Larry, where are you calling from?
Ringing offshore at work this morning.
Oh, really? Okay, and you have a question today for?
Mr. Music.
I thought so. What's your question, Larry?
We wanted to know who recorded Bob Rand.
Oh, the Beach Boys did that.
The Beach Boys did that.
Right, Bob,
Jan
Bob, Bob.
Jan and Dean never recorded that.
What's that?
Jan and Dean never recorded that.
Well, they helped out. Are you also, there are a couple other versions on it. Well, there's one guy who had a version apparently never got released, and seriously, he wanted to make a version of Bomb Iran, set to the melody of Bomb, 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 Bomb Iran. Never got on the market, I guess. 7:21. It's true. K-Hits 97. KHTC. K-Hits 97. And Charlie Tuna and a hungry heart. Bruce Springsteen. 7:24, Ed Arnold here in a minute. Oh, I got another guy on the phone here. We were filling in the blank listening to K-Hits 97 at work is like, and what did you say?
Okay, listen to K-Hits is like receiving a hickey from Bo Derek.
Wyatt Earp, Marshall?
Sorry to disappoint you, sir.
I lose.
Nope, you win.
Our what?
Announcing the What's My Specialty quiz game at Burger King. It's easy to win, so if you expect to lose, we're sorry to disappoint you.
Ty Cobb, baseball?
Sorry, ma'am, you win.
No kidding.
Every game card can win. Just choose the correct answer on your Burger King What's My Specialty card and get a free regular Coke, fries, or delicious specialty sandwich. Come in often and save winning cards for the biggest prizes. What's My Specialty at Burger King. If you expect to lose, Charles Lindbergh, pilot, sorry.
Oh. We lose.
You win.
Oh, wow. Houdini, magician.
Sorry, sir.
Sorry, sir.
You win.
I win.
Play What's My Specialty.
I win.
You win.
Play What's My Specialty.
I win! I win!
That's what I've been trying to tell you, sir!
Make it Burger King!
Details at participating restaurants. Get a game card with any purchase. Game runs through March 15th, 1981, or while supply lasts. Void where prohibited.
Isn't everything. 7:25, and now here's something it isn't. It's Ed Arnold. Good morning, Ed.
Good morning, Charlie.
Before you get started, Ed, I have got a listener on the phone here who has a question for you. All right?
All right, but if I can't answer, you're gonna fill in for me?
Well, no, I think you can maybe...
Oh, good.
Maybe you won't want to answer. Okay. Hi, who is this?
This is Rick Boyd calling Long Beach.
Yeah, Rick, and what was your question for Ed?
Ed, I got to find out, where the heck did ABC find that lousy announcer for the Kenya Gold Cup boxing this weekend?
I haven't the foggiest idea. That's network. That comes out of New York.
So, Ed, what...
Of course, they knew that I had to stay here in Los Angeles, right?
Okay.
To be honest.
You don't?
No.
Okay.
I'm sure that they found him back in New York someplace.
All right, thank you.
You know, it's funny, and what the fellow just brought up is something that a lot of people don't realize, that most of the announcers, play-by-play people they use, they get back east, and they have back east. And the last few years, some of the networks have realized, hey, you know, we've been missing the boat, and they've got Vin Scully from out here. Of course, that's CBS, and CBS using Jim Hill. ABC wisely used Ted Dawson on a couple of college games this year. Mm-hmm. And so they're finding out that, hey, there's some good ones. Of course, Keith Jackson, I think, who is the best college play-by-play football announcer around, is from out here.
Why did he grow the beard, really?
I think he just enjoyed it. Something
change?
Different.
Yeah, okay.
A change. You know, Keith from Oklahoma, and he's been out here for a number of years, and boy, is he fantastic.
That's right. Well, you've got the Mr. Sports here this morning, Ed. What do you have?
Well, the Lakers and Kings both enjoyed 59, and number 5, LSU, beat number 6, Kentucky, 81-67, and that's sports.
By the way, we have a lot of Ed Arnold fans out there, too, Ed. A lady just called in, too, and wanted to know if they wanted to get a hold of you for one reason or another. What, Channel 7? Just leave a message over there?
Yeah, Channel 7. And, I want to mention about Channel 7, too. You know, we talk about things that we do. Someone asked me last night where Ted Dawson was. He's in New Orleans for a couple of days doing some Super Bowl stuff for us. And I get the first report tonight at 6, I hope.
Okay, we'll look for it.
Okay.
Check with you in 30 minutes.
All right.
728, K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97, Santuna with Charlie Tuna and Evil Ways.
Good morning. 7:31, I'm Boyd R. Britton, and here's your news. The news you're waiting to hear, that the plane has taken off from Tehran, is not yet ready, unfortunately. Everything else seems to be. This morning, the U.S. announced, Algeria transmitted, and Iran confirmed the word that the money has been transferred to the Algerian escrow account in London, that the Iranian assets are unfrozen, that we did all that we promised to do, and they have promised to let that plane leave. Fred Kennedy in London of NBC is our principal source on all this stuff lately, and he has the latest.
Well, it's dark in Tehran now. The airplane just half a mile down the runway from air traffic control tower is testing its lights alongside a van to transport the passengers. From their vantage point high above the runway, the airport officials say they see little, only an almost abandoned airport plunged into darkness due to the blackout enforced because of the war with Iraq. The airport is out of bounds to anyone not connected with the hostage flight. Only airport workers, police, and young Revolutionary Guards patrol. The Algerian doctors are ready to go home. The planes are fueled and flight tested. Still, the hostages wait, but not for long.
Ronald Reagan's big day has begun. He and Nancy Reagan went to St. John's Episcopal Church this morning for pre-inaugural prayer, joined by Mr. and Mrs. George Bush. The Reagans will call at the White House in just a few minutes. Perhaps even now the motorcade may be pulling up for coffee with the Carters. Then it's on to the Capitol, where the oath of office will be administered to the new president at 9. At age 69, Ronald Reagan is the oldest man elected to the office, the first actor, the first divorced man, and you can argue till you're blue in the face as to whether Grover Cleveland's two terms in office make Reagan the 39th or 40th president of this land. Pennsylvania Avenue is decked out with red, white, and blue bunting for the ride to the White House after they leave the Capitol, and police and other security forces have gathered around the entire area, of course, keeping control of a crowd that could grow to 100,000 by 9 o'clock our time. Spring-like weather. Maybe they won't need those heaters behind the bulletproof glass at the Capitol. They say it'll be in the 50s. At St. John's Church this morning, Reagan was asked if he was cheered by the hostage developments. He said, of course, we're all delighted. We'll just wait, though, till they are airborne. Some people in Washington are probably still airborne from last night's big party. Ronald Reagan probably could have made it in the movies, said Johnny Carson, if he could draw that many people to his films, the way he drew votes and a crowd last night for the big gala.
Ronald Reagan spent his last night as a private citizen at a star-studded spectacular put on by his old Hollywood friend Frank Sinatra. 20,000 cheering fans poured into the Capital Center Sports Arena outside Washington for the event. Sinatra sang My Kind of Town, Chicago Is, and New York, New York, and Ethel Merman belted out Everything's Coming Up Roses. Comedian Johnny Carson complimented Nancy Reagan for doing a wonderful decorating job on the hall, but he added, I wonder how she got the hockey team to move out early. Reagan told the crowd that it finally sunk in during the program. He will finally become the nation's 40th president.
Wise variable high clouds through Wednesday, the high today in the low 70s, and it's now 60 downtown.
I think you'll recall we had a geologist up in Northern California, Jim Birkeland of San Jose, Boyd.
The Santa Clara County fellow.
Right, and he said there was an earthquake window that we all go through, and I think probably we're approaching another earthquake window because I saw last night the big full moon and everything, and that's really correlated. Right. There's one other addition, though, he wants to make to the list. He said, watch the lost cat ads in the newspaper. He said, January 13th, there were 6 lost cat ads, and on the 15th, that number rose to 9. And sure enough, up in the San Jose area, they had a quake registered about 5 on the Richter scale on January 15th. He says, animals apparently can sense a quake coming, get nervous, and they run away.
Oh, we've heard that before.
Yeah, and he's checked the past earthquake and lost animal records, and he says the results bear out his theory.
Yeah, but I'd hate to wait for the next day's paper saying, killer quake hits, and then in the back pages, lost kitty $5. You know, come on. Need a little more lead time.
7:36. Can we get a cat as our staff earthquake predictor here?
How about a chimp? Hey, don't be a chump. Think chimp. Chimps are in for the 80s. I'll explain later. It has nothing to do with Bonzo either.
K-Hits 97. KHTZ. K-Hits 97. Charlie Tuna and Steely Dan. And hey, 19. Boy, it really has a generation gap exposes itself when you hear him talking about the Soul Survivors. I remember them. Remember Expressway to Your Heart? And Aretha Franklin? Who can't but 19 dozen? 7:41. And this Thursday night on our K-Hits Concert Special, we'll be featuring the music of Steely Dan for 1 hour, uninterrupted by commercials. That's Thursday night at 8, only here at K-Hits 97. Oh, one other thing. I got a guy on the phone who's been patiently waiting. We were talking about our little theme that we kicked around at work last week. Listening to K-Hits 97 at work is like. And another guy called up, and you have an idea about that?
To me, K-Hits is like a warm toilet seat on a cold morning.
A word for both men and women. Unless you're perfectly satisfied with your present job, consider a career that pays up to $22,000 to start and offers real opportunity for advancement. The career is with the Los Angeles Police Department, and there are 500 immediate openings. The need is especially critical for women, blacks, and Hispanics, and the LAPD now provides special pre-training to help you qualify. If you're 21 to 34 and have a high school diploma or a GED, call 386-LAPD or 485-LAPD. You just might like what you hear.
Miller's Outpost is going to kick inflation right in the...
Hit it! We got the fashions you can't star in.
If you've been waiting for a chance to save money on brand-name fashion clothing for guys and gals, then the Miller's Outpost clearance sale is surely an opportunity you don't want to miss. Like the fantastic savings on fashion pants by Levi's, Britannia, Grapevines, Angel's Flight, and many more. Now only $9.94 each. Choose from the most popular styles in cord, denim, either casual or dress, and all your favorite colors, just $9.94 each. Or men's and ladies' fashion tops and shirts, just $7.94 each. Wovens, knits, flannels, just to name a few from some of the most famous brand names in the business. Now, these fashions are not seconds. These fashions are not irregulars, but first quality, top-of-the-line fashions cut so far below their regular price, you won't believe it. So hurry for best selection. The chance you've been waiting for is here.
At Miller's Outpost.
Sale ends January 28th at a Miller's Outpost near you.
It's 7:42, morning traffic update. Southbound Golden State transition to the southbound Pasadena Freeway. They have an accident with an injury at that location. That's southbound Golden State transition to the southbound Pasadena. The San Bernardino Freeway east of Baldwin Park Boulevard, westbound, they have an accident. Harbor Freeway south of Florence, northbound, there's another accident. Traffic is slowed in that area. And the real problem of the morning is southbound on the Santa Ana Freeway at the Laguna Freeway. An earlier accident, an oil spill, about 1,000 gallons of oil, I understand, spilled there. All the southbound lanes of the Santa Ana are closed in that area, probably throughout the morning while they clean the mess up, and the freeway is really backed up. And southbound Santa Ana at the Laguna Freeway for you this morning, in case you run into all the taillights that are flashing. It's 7:43. Oh, and a thank you today for our lady who sent me the morning wake-up story, Diane, I hope I pronounce this, Diane, Klewein. It's K-L-E-W-E-I-N, or Klewein or Kluwin, maybe. And Diane of Bellflower. Thank you very much, because Boyd mentioned a moment ago about chimps being in. All right, so with that in mind, 7:44, time now for boys and girls of all ages to gather around their radios for the morning wake-up story. Once upon a time, two chimps were sitting in their cage at the zoo, one with a Bible in one hand and Darwin's theory in the other. After reading them both back and forth, going back from one to the other, and so forth, over and over, his companion finally turned and asked, "What's wrong?" The one chimp replied, "I don't understand it. Am I my brother's keeper or am I my keeper's brother?" Thought for the day. 7:44, K-Hits 97, KHTZ. KHTZ. K-Hits 97, Charlie Tuna and Randy Van Warmer. Whatever happened to him? Out warming vans somewhere, yes, and just when I needed you most. It's 7:48, well, just when I needed her most to tell me the pronunciation on her name, she's on the phone. This is Diane from Bellflower. What's the pronunciation, Diane?
Claywine.
All right, well, thank you very much for the morning wake-up story today.
You're welcome.
I appreciate your efforts. How long have you been listening now?
Oh, about 2 years, I think.
You do
listen to you on another station.
Oh, there have been several other stations in 2 years, probably. All right. Thank you. Do you listen to us at work?
No, I can't. I work for a veterinarian, and
I know. You don't want us talking.
It's inappropriate, huh?
Talking to the animals. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
And let's see. I have somebody on this phone here talking about listening to K-Hits at work is like, what was your suggestion?
Listening to K-Hits at work is like having company over and getting paid for it.
Thank you. K-Hits.
I have another winner for your K-Hits. Listen to K-Hits is like.
All right.
Okay, it's like living upwind from the Chicago Stockyards.
All right. Thank you. 7:49, Los Angeles weather is going to be some night and morning low clouds. Otherwise, variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. The high today and tomorrow is 72. Overnight, down to the 50s. Civic Center, it's 57. Reverse that and you got the humidity reading, 75%. It's overcast in the beaches, 58. In Orange County, clouds in 58. The valley's overcast, 53. Down in San Diego, it's partly cloudy, fog and haze in 56. Oh, and one of our star listeners I'll talk to in a second.
And here are the final results. For the 12th year in a row, Concepts in Comfort is number one on the best rest list. Yes, Concepts in Comfort is the one. Nobody sells a better night's sleep for less than Concepts in Comfort. That's right, nobody. Ask anybody. Everybody knows it. Listen, the Buttonwood, $159 complete. The Bookshelf, $169 complete. The Bedside Four-Poster, $179 complete. Imagine, at Concepts in Comfort, complete bed start at only $99. And this month, save hundreds of dollars on hundreds of unadvertised specials. Closeouts, one-of-a-kind beds, and bedroom furniture. See one of our friendly, experienced sales staff and make us open 7 days. Phone 994-9461.
Mention this station and get a free set of sheets with the purchase of any Wavecrest, no ocean motion waveless mattress. This Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Imagine this. It's noontime. You're standing with a plate in your hand. And there it is, bowls of golden fried chicken. Your favorite kinds of pizza, fresh from the oven, and crowned with a choice of toppings. Pepperoni, black olives, mushrooms, sausage. And there, just a little to your right, is a salad bar arrayed with all the fresh, good things you need to create your own grand green feast. Imagine yourself enjoying anything or everything you see and paying next to nothing for the privilege. Imagine that. Now come and get it at Shakey's.
And imagine paying about $3.21 plus tax per person for Shakey's Luncheon Buffet. Every Monday through Friday, 11 to 1:30 p.m. Products and prices may vary at participating Shakey's.
7:51, here's a guy who is one of our regulars for the past year and a half, I guess, K-Hits has been on the air. It's Justin Dana. Good morning, Justin. How are you doing today?
Pretty good.
I'm not making you late for school, you said, right?
No.
Okay, I wouldn't want to get you in trouble here. But Justin has been, well, what are all your credits now on television? You were on one very dramatic show. When was it, a couple of months ago?
Yeah, To Find My Son.
That's right. All right, and you played the son in that.
Yeah.
And you've got another movie coming out, you say?
Yeah.
What's
called Incredible Shrinking Woman.
Oh, Lily Tomlin's movie.
Yeah.
That's going to be coming out, what, first part of February here?
Yeah.
Boy, that must be exciting.
Yep, sure you, is.
Are you bigger than the Incredible Shrinking Woman?
Well, yeah. Thankfully.
How old are you now?
10.
And you've, how many TV shows have you done now? Have you stopped to add them up at this point in your career?
So far, the most is four, I think, five, six.
And you really aspire to be an actor full-time when you get older, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Here, you're having second thought. Have you got a have you got a girlfriend yet, by the way, Justin?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Who's your, or, well, maybe I can report this to the Hollywood Reporter later on, or Rona Barrett. Who's your girlfriend?
Kristen.
Is she a professional?
No.
No. Not in the movies or television?
Well, yeah. No, she's not in the movie business.
Oh. But
she, you know, she goes to my school and stuff.
Oh, I see. It's hard to combine sometimes a career and have a relationship and everything else. All right. Well, you keep me posted, Justin, on how things are going out there.
All right.
You're a very talented young man, and I know in the future I'm going to say I knew Justin Dana when. Thanks for calling, Justin.
Okay, thanks. Bye.
Oops, my time is up. 7:53. K-Hits 97. KHTZ. Our life. Good morning. It's 8:01. I'm Boyd R. Britton, and here's your news, such as it is, on the 444th day of the ordeal of 52 Americans and the rest of us concerning Iran. The whole nation still waits breathlessly for any word, a yes, or maybe two words. Wheels up would be nice to hear. According to NBC's Fred Kennedy in London, everything's set at the airport now. There had been delays, but they're waiting in Tehran for a takeoff. One unconfirmed report, absolutely unconfirmed, that one of the planes did leave. And when those burn off, high clouds and a high temp in the low 70s, looking now at 62 downtown.
Oh, one note here about Nancy Reagan and her decorators. They should remember when they move into the White House, the furniture there isn't purchased with taxpayer money. It's donated by private parties. That's one tradition.
Oh, I thought they got it at Levitt's.
No, Richard Nixon wasn't aware of that. When he took office, he decided the White House cabinet room needed a new oval table. But he found out about it when he got a bill for about $10,000 from the GSA and a note thanking him for his contribution. He paid the tab, by the way. Horrible. 8:06 and Tears of a Clown. Smokey and the Miracles. K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. Charlie Tuna and Smokey and the Tears of a Clown. Your makeup's running. 8:10, we'll check the morning traffic for you in a second.
Rosalita knows a neater way to cook. Rosalita knows a neater way.
Rosarita knows that to make the best-tasting, best-selling refried beans in America, you have to start with the best hand-picked beans.
Rosarita knows a neater way.
Morning traffic update here at 8:11. Foothill Freeway around Berkshire, westbound. They have an accident. Traffic may be slowed there. Hollywood Freeway between Burbank and Magnolia Boulevard. Inbound traffic slowed in that area. The Golden State Freeway south of 4th Street. Southbound, they have a minor accident. CHP is on the scene. Traffic slowed. And our big problem of the morning, the Santa Ana Freeway below the Laguna Freeway in Orange County, southbound. An earlier oil spill, about 1,000 gallons of oil spill, being cleaned up. That happened early this morning. All the southbound lanes of the Santa Ana Freeway are closed in that area. And I had no listener reports how far the backup is. Maybe if somebody had to get off could tell us exactly where that thing is. I imagine it's a couple of miles at this point. But southbound Santa Ana Freeway below the Laguna Freeway in Orange County is closed in that area. People are being diverted off at the Laguna Freeway just because of the tremendous backup. It's 8:12, and that's your traffic.
The unbelievable.
Isn't it? The typical squirrel takes about 10 naps a day. We have a lot of squirrels in this radio audience. The average American sees about 11 movies a year and eats about 77 hot dogs. Not necessarily in that order. 40% of wounds caused by knives, guns, and ice picks are inflicted by friends or relatives of the victim. That's why I never argue with my wife while she's drying the knives. And the most often left behind in motels are electric razor cords. And what? No, no names, please.
The unbelievable.
8:12. Barry Manilow from K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. Charlie Tuna, Barry Manilow. I made it through the rain. 8:16. Well, the big inauguration is going to be taking place in Washington, D.C., just about an hour from right now. And on the telephone, we'll be talking in just a second to Jason Kane from Ron Smith's Celebrity Lookalikes, because there is another, well, what would appear to be a Ronald and Nancy Reagan walking around the streets of Washington, and Jason will fill us in on what's been going on with him. It's wild. Los Angeles weather is tonight, morning low clouds, otherwise variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. High today and tomorrow, 72 overnight, down to the middle 50s, and the temps this morning, incidentally, high yesterday was 70, so it's been more normal than usual. Just no rain. They say maybe by the weekend there's a possibility now, some rain moving in. It's 56 Civic Center, humidity at 77%, it's overcast in the beaches, 59, cloudy in Orange County, it's 58, and overcast in the valley is 58. They had some earlier morning fog out there, and partly cloudy in San Diego, it's 57.
You have a certain style, a free and easy flair. You have a special smile that comes from knowing your style. Facing life
1978, Freestyle introduced a fresh new approach in professional haircutting, and in those two short years, Freestyle has proven.
We can cut it!
They can cut it. They can give you the exact style cut you want for only $6, and with six locations in Southern California, it proves they can cut it. Come in with clean hair, and like 200,000 people before you, you'll leave singing.
Freestyle!
Today through January 27th, Freestyle is giving a limited number of $3 orientation cuts at a Santa Monica location. Call 828-0928 for your appointment. It's 819 on the telephone now. I have Jason Kane from Ron Smith's Celebrity Lookalikes. Morning, Jason.
Good morning, Charlie. How are you?
I understand you say Ron is back in Washington today, right?
That's right. We spoke a couple of weeks ago. We were trying to find the caller who called in on your show saying that they knew someone that looked like Ronald Reagan.
Uh-huh.
And I came on the air asking to try to find that person. Well, we had over 45 people that responded to that call just for the Ronald Reagan, plus I don't know how many hundreds of others called lookalikes. So, I mean, your show is phenomenal from that point of view.
Wow.
And we found, from your show, we found a Ronald Reagan lookalike, and Ron Smith, President of Ron Smith Celebrity Lookalikes, is in Washington, D.C. with both the Ronald and Nancy Reagan lookalike, and they're throwing an unofficial inaugural ball today at Tramp's restaurant and nightclub in the Georgetown area. And one of the funny things is that while they were there, they arrived Sunday, and they started getting mobbed by people, and Ron applied to the Secret Service to get protection for the Ronald and Nancy Reagan because they are such dead ringers. They said, well, they couldn't do it, so we had to hire our own security force to protect the Ronald and Nancy Reagan from all the people out there who think that they're the real Ronald and Nancy Reagan.
That just adds to the impact, I bet.
It sure does, and so it's all because of you, Charlie, that we found the Ronald Reagan, and I just can't thank you enough for your help and your listeners for, calling in on the show.
Somebody's got a new career for 4 or maybe 8 years, right?
That's right, and he's just, I mean, he is amazing. We'd love to have him come down one day to your show and meet you.
That'd be great to get some pictures with that one. Well, now, you said at that time, too, though, you could use maybe just more than one lookalike, right?
Yeah, the way the calls are coming in right now, we still can use another Ronald or Nancy Reagan. In fact, we're also looking for a Tip O'Neill and an Anson Williams lookalike.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So if you look like a celebrity, the bottom line is you can call Ron Smith Celebrity Lookalikes.
That's right. And you can call us at 213-273-5566. And we're also listed in Los Angeles at the 9000 Sunset Building as Ron Smith Celebrity Lookalikes.
All right.
And please call. And, they're all in Washington right now. And we'll give you a call and let you know how things are going as the days progress.
I love it. By the way, one final question, Jason. Does the Ronald Reagan the lookalike have naturally dark hair?
He is perfect. He has naturally dark hair. In fact, one of the very strange things about David Becker, who is the Ronald Reagan lookalike,
uh-huh.
He has looked like Ronald Reagan since he was young. When Ronald Reagan was in movies, people mistook David Becker for the Ronald Reagan. I saw pictures of David from well back when he was in his 20s and 30s, and he was exactly like Ronald Reagan in those days.
Have they ever met each other? Did he tell you that?
No, they've never met each other yet, but I think that we were invited, where Ron Smith was invited to a couple of inauguration and a couple of the balls,
uh-huh.
And they're going to be there tonight just stopping by, and we, like I said, we're holding our own ball, so maybe Ronald and Nancy Reagan are going to stop by at our inaugurational ball.
Well, as busy as the presidential office is these days, he could probably use a clone or somebody looks like him just for some functions occasionally.
You got it. I'm telling you, you got it. So remember, we are looking for Tip O'Neill and Anson Williams.
All right. Thank you, Jason Kane. Ron Smith, Celebrity Lookalikes.
Thank you, Charlie. Bye-bye.
Seeing is not always believing, unless you're seeing the right woman. 822, K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. And Charlie Tuna, still rock and roll to me. That's Billy Joel. 825, my telephone's open, 520-9797, L.A. in the Valleys, Orange County, 714 area. You can always dial us at 977-1020.
An unplanned pregnancy is hard to deal with. Think about it. Who do you talk to? Where do you go? The doctors at West Coast Medical Group have helped thousands of women in the last 10 years. Call now, 856 8655.
Doctor?
I'm afraid so, Mr. Quigley.
I've really turned into a blob.
Look at yourself. You're flabby, shapeless.
Tired all the time.
Generally pretty blobby.
Is there a cure, Doctor?
Yes, there is. I'm sending you to the sports connection.
You mean?
Within a short time, you'll be completely deblobbed, yes.
Goodbye, blobs?
Yes, and you'll have fun doing it, because at the sports connection, you can play racquetball, go swimming, the gymnastic classes, Nautilus equipment.
They won't laugh at my funny knees?
These knees look fine.
Those are my shoulders, Doctor.
Oh, well, I wouldn't worry, Mr. Quigley. The sports connection has lots of friendly people who just want to help you get back into shape, whatever that was.
Oh, great.
You can stand up now.
I am standing up.
Then turn around and face me.
I am facing you.
Is that your nose?
Yes.
De-blob yourself at the sports connection, the total fitness center.
Okay, you've had your holiday fun. Now's the time to get serious about getting back into shape, to get you moving in the right direction. The Sports Connection is now offering 2 years for the price of one. That's a 2-year membership for the price of one, right now at all Sports Connection locations, Santa Monica, Beverly Hills, and Encino. I have a lady here on the telephone. Hi, who is this?
This is Sunny.
Hi, Sunny. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from my work in Huntington Park, where I work.
Oh, you've taken K-Hits to work. Good.
I have for a long time. Can't get along without it.
What did you say now your boss said?
He wants us to announce on the loudspeaker that the airplane took off with the hostages.
Ah.
I haven't heard on your radio yet that
no,
they have.
We have no confirmation. As a matter of fact, we are right now monitoring the NBC line that basically has a setup that can find out exactly the second the wheels lift off, and Boyd R. is going to be monitoring that. We have had the word that it's supposed to maybe take off here in just a couple of minutes, and we're going to keep our line open on NBC, our affiliated network, and the minute we have it, of course, we'll have it right on the air. So all that will be coming up here.
Hi, Sonny, you can make the announcement.
Okay, you'll get your chance. Keep listening.
Okay,
day 28, K-Hits 97, KHTZ.
Good morning. It's 8:32. I'm Boyd R. Britton, and here's your news. Supposedly, according to NBC correspondent Fred Kennedy in London, the hostage planes were supposed to have taken off from Tehran at 8:30 sharp our time, following some ceremonies there at the airport in the Iranian capital. The PARS news agency said the departure was imminent. Associated Press, the Western news agency, says one plane has taken off. We cannot confirm that. Here's what we can give you from correspondent Kennedy in London.
On hand at the airport at this very moment is Iran's chief negotiator, Nabavi, and America's representative in Iran, the Swiss ambassador. Their presence at the departure will formally conclude the 14-month-old hostage crisis. The hostages are aboard. They're passengers now. The plane's engines are roaring. It's ready for takeoff. All this is happening at a time when Ronald Reagan is supposed to be taking the center stage in Washington. Source correspondent C.D. Jaco is in Washington for the inauguration.
Fred, I'm at the reviewing stand across from the White House as last-minute preparations are being made. In less than an hour, Ronald Reagan becomes the 40th president. But while all eyes are on the Capitol, the minds of most people here and their hearts are on the tarmac at Tehran Airport. It's pretty safe to say that for most people here, including those involved with putting this inaugural together and making the last-minute preparations, the event is being overshadowed by the other events taking place half a world away. If the hostages are taking off from Tehran Airport, then the inaugural celebrations here will certainly have something else to celebrate. Most people here along the parade route are carrying radios. They say they want to see the inauguration, but they want to listen to the latest updated news about the hostages. So again, while people here are happy about this event, they are much, much happier about the word that the hostages may be leaving.
Yeah, they may be leaving any minute now. They may have taken off in the past 4 minutes. 8:30, our time, the scheduled time for their departure, according to a Tehran airport official talking with an NBC newsman in London. That's the best we can give you on day 444. Hopefully, the last day of the Iran hostage crisis, at least for 52 Americans. We still don't know the fate of American journalist and accused spy Cynthia Dwyer of Buffalo, New York. The new administration coming in, the Carters and the Reagans at the Capitol already. Their motorcade left the White House after a little coffee clatch earlier this morning in church for the president-elect and the new First Lady at St. John's Episcopal in Washington, D.C. Anyway, at 9 o'clock, we'll be bringing you, hopefully live, or at least delayed only a few seconds on tape, the taking of the oath of office by the 40th President of the United States, and excerpts from the speech this morning. Variable high clouds in the afternoon today and tomorrow, and a high in the low 70s. It's 62 downtown.
I was just monitoring the NBC line, and all we have so far is the Washington inaugural going on, as best I can tell. Right, Boyd?
As far as I can tell, let's see. Yeah, they're still inaugurating themselves over there.
It must be a crazy day for reporters. They got one ear, I'm sure, based on Iran.
Schizophrenia. I'm Boyd R. Britton.
Wait. I've just got a flash here from Russ Spears. We're getting... Russ, why don't you check with Boyd in the newsroom?
Okay, just a moment. United Press may have something.
United Press.
Let me check it.
Bring it up here. What do we got? We're getting the word maybe that they have taken off?
Will take place.
What's it?
Can't tell you.
Let's see. Will change planes to two C-9 Nightingale.
This is UPI.
Hospital jets for the three-hour flight onward to Rhein-Main Air Base near Frankfurt, West Germany. From there, they have only one more short leg to cover, and it's a 30-minute bus ride west to the city of Wiesbaden and the home comforts prepared for them here at the U.S. Air Force Hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Edwin Smith, Wiesbaden, West Germany.
I think that was just a regular news feed cut.
We have
the departure. It's coming in as a bulletin feed.
It came in as a bulletin feed that we missed, got in the very end of it. But apparently, Russ Spears in the news
department
right now.
UPI now confirming an 8:30 departure from Tehran.
That's right. And we'll have we'll get the complete bulletin here for us in just a second.
Okay. Hooray.
Yeah.
It's true.
That sounds super. It's 8:37. K-Hits 97. KHTZ, K-Hits 97. And Charlie Tuna, it's 8:41. Ain't no stopping us now. Well, we'll find out. Boyd R. is back with me here to get the full context of that report we just got in on the tail end. Boyd?
The full context of that report, which was from Wiesbaden, West Germany, from United Press International, not from Tehran or from London or from any of our other sources, but did say that both planes, one carrying the 52 American hostages, the other carrying their baggage and belongings, did take off this morning at about 8:30 our time from Tehran, bound for Algiers, the hostages bound for freedom. As the correspondent said on the line from Europe, the hostages are free. This, according to one source, NBC had predicted an 8:30 takeoff. Associated Press had said that at least one plane had taken off prior to 8:30, but it is actually happening. As is the inaugural, I'm getting back to that, and we'll have more, hopefully, very good news for you on K-Hits 97 between now and 9 o'clock.
We found your next house, America. We found the house you wanted.
Direct or collect.
It's 8:44, and just a second ago, we have an NBC report we'll get you an instant replay on concerning the hostages. First of all, a problem, Santa Ana Freeway at the Laguna Freeway southbound. They are still clearing an earlier oil spill with all southbound lanes closed, CHP advises. Southbound traffic is backed up to the Newport Freeway. The northbound traffic also very slow due to the rubberneckers. CHP advises motorists to use the San Diego Freeway and avoid that area. That's the Santa Ana Freeway southbound at the Laguna Freeway. They're still clearing that earlier oil spill. All the southbound lanes are closed. CHP advises southbound traffic backed up to the Newport. Northbound traffic very slow, too. Hollywood Freeway north of Alvarado southbound, a minor accident. The Harbor Freeway at 51st Street northbound, they have a two-car accident. And now, Boyd R. with the further update, this time from NBC. Boyd?
We can confirm the hostages have been released from Tehran. The planes are off the ground, headed for Turkey, then Algiers, then the hostages headed for home. Fred Kennedy of NBC News in London picked up the same report that UPI picked up in Wiesbaden and, of course, that we had heard earlier on the Associated Press. But it didn't happen until after 8:30. He was right about that.
Air traffic control says some 7 minutes ago, the red and white Boeing 727s roared down the runway one after another, and Tehran air traffic control and the city itself were lost in the dark. Air traffic says the 52 hostages accompanied by six Algerian doctors will arrive in Algiers in about 7 to 7.5 hours. Few people saw the Americans depart. One person who did was Iran's chief hostage negotiator, Nabavi. Most of the airport was closed off for the occasion. The last thing the hostages saw were young, armed revolutionary guards. It's nighttime in Tehran. For the hostages, it's good night and goodbye. Fred Kennedy, NBC News, London.
444 days later, thank God it's over. The hostages are free. I'm Boyd R. Britton, K-Hits 97.
8:46. And as a disc jockey, sometimes you're at a loss for words, so let the music do the talking. And this says it all from Neil Diamond, America, on K-Hits 97.
think our pen will say our prey. Freedom is light burning warm. Freedom is light burning warm. Everywhere around the world, they come to America. Every time that flag's unfurled, they come to America. Got a dream to take them there. They come to America. Got a dream they come to share.
KHTZ, K-Hits, 97, Charlie Tuna. It's 8:50. It's funny because I was just sitting here reflecting and listening to that. A lady just goes, just keep playing that song. She said that's the best thing that has ever been said. And I was just sitting here thinking about the emotional impact. I just got goosebumps finally when that word was that they are airborne. And I was thinking back to the hockey team's victory. And, you know, you thought that nothing could top that as emotional as a moment that was. But I think as an American, you really have to feel good right now. It's over. Los Angeles weather, some night, morning, low clouds. Otherwise, variable high cloudiness through tomorrow. High today of 72, overnight down to the 50s. It's 56 downtown.
Navy port of call, the Riviera.
Take 52, and here's Leo Sayer. More than I can say. Boy, that is... K-Hits 97. It's 8:57, and as a final note, Boyd R. will have the update on what has happened so far. The hostages are airborne and back on their way to freedom. And this seems appropriate. Chicago on K-Hits 97. KHTZ. That's Chicago and free. And that's going to have to can it today for the Charlie Tuna Show. Thank you very much for sharing your morning with me. And this has probably been about the happiest note to ever end a show on. We'll be back tomorrow. Neil Ross up after the news. And that's the big story of the morning.
Good morning. I'm Boyd R. Britton. Here's your news at a minute till nine. The hostages are free and Ronald Wilson Reagan is president of the United States. Let us take the most recent event first. Less than 2.5 minutes ago, Chief Justice Warren Burger, standing in the west porch of the Capitol building in Washington, D.C., administered the oath of office to the 40th president.
You place your left hand on the Bible and raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Ronald Reagan, do solemnly swear.
I, Ronald Reagan, do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
And will, to the best of my ability,
and will to the best of my ability,
preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
So help me God.